In this section, we will cover an introduction to the history of debits and credits, the need for financial recording system, Lucia Pacioli, the father of accounting, the confusion about the terms debit and credit, a definition of the terms debit and credit, and then a brief summary. Debits and credits is a key component of a financial record system known as double entry bookkeeping. This system was first used by the Venetian merchants of Italy in the 15th century Renaissance period. It was documented in Latin in 1494 and then translated into English in the 16th century. With the passage of over 500 years, is it any wonder that we have become a little confused about the original meaning of these accounting concepts? Complicating it further is the fact that the English language has evolved, giving new meanings to these age-old words and concepts. So as we try to understand the concept of debit and credit, it may be beneficial for us to go back to where it all began, to see if we can understand what the Venetians saw when they used the terms debit and credits in the double entry bookkeeping system. In more primitive times, there was little need to record financial transactions because the person who made the goods was usually the person who sold the goods in the marketplace. However, in the 15th century Renaissance period, there was a huge increase in interstate trade brought about by the Roman-built transport systems and the growth of more sophisticated societies like those in Venice, Italy. At that time, Venetian entrepreneurs were creating enterprises in an effort to satisfy the increased desire for goods required of their society. So they began trading with one another, with other cities, and with other states. This new trading in goods between different entities created quite complex financial dealings because it involved many financial transactions between many different stakeholders. The rise of banks and investors who funded these enterprises further complicated the process and increased the need for objective financial status reports. To deal with this new complexity, the merchants of Venice developed the double entry bookkeeping system to accurately record financial transactions so that they could monitor the monies owed, the assets owned, and the profitability of their enterprises. A Franciscan friar and mathematician from that era, Lucia Pacioli, was the first to document and publish this system in a book. His book was first published on the Gutenberg Press in 1494 and was the only accounting textbook for over 100 years. Lucia is acknowledged today as the father of accounting. Lucia's book outlined the entire double entry bookkeeping system, and it included a section on debits and credits. Now, while this system was developed over 500 years ago, its principles and process are still followed today by accountants and bookkeepers the world over. When Lucia first recorded the double entry bookkeeping system in 1494, he did so in Latin, which was the language at the time. So Lucia used the Latin terms creditor and debitor to describe what he saw as the dual impact that financial transactions have on the accounts of a business. By looking at the meanings of the Latin words creditor and debitor, we may get a clue as to why Lucia would have chosen these terms in particular. See, creditor in Latin means to entrust something, and debitor means to owe to someone. So the Latin terms creditor would have been used at the time when a bank loaned or entrusted money to a business. And the Latin term debitor would have been used to describe the fact that the business now owes money of equal value back to the bank. In a sense, each of these terms describe a different side of the same transaction. So it made sense then for Lucia to adopt these terms in the double entry bookkeeping system to describe the dual impact that financial transactions have on the accounts of a business. In the 1500s, English translators then translated these Latin terms as credit and debit, respectively. Furthermore, understanding that the English word debit comes from the Latin word debitor helps explain why we use DR and CR as abbreviations for debit and credit today. See, there's no R in the English word debit, but there is an R in the Latin term debitor. So quite possibly, today's convention of using DR as an abbreviation for debit is simply a carryover from the time when the Latin term debito was in use. English is an evolving language that has developed many different meanings over time for the terms debit and credit, other than the ones originally used for accounting during the 15th century. In fact, if you look at most dictionaries, you will discover over 10 different meanings for the term credit, including the specific one that we use in accounting. Some students even try to relate the term debit with debt, yet these two terms have no relationship, even though they have very similar sounding tones. Is it any wonder, then, that the debit and credit concept is a difficult one for 21st century students to understand? As we begin to understand these concepts, it is very important to realize that debits and credits are terms that have unique and specific meaning for the double entry bookkeeping system. So the terms debit and credit in accounting have no relationship with any other meaning of these terms. It is these various meanings and the attempt by students of accounting to form a relationship between these meanings that causes the most confusion. For example, the term credit today has many different meanings. Credit can mean to ascribe an achievement to someone, or the ability of a customer to obtain goods or services before payment, or even to represent money lent or made available under an arrangement, or further, the acknowledgement of a grade level in an examination, or finally, a source of pride that reflects well on another person or organization. The accounting meaning of the term credit should not be confused with any of these meanings, nor should the term debit be likened with the concept of debt. Furthermore, debit and credit has no relationship with the concepts of good and bad, nor positive or negative, nor even increase and decrease. So the first step to making sense of the terms debit and credit is to understand that only their accounting meaning has relevance to bookkeeping. The terms debit and credit are used in the double entry bookkeeping system as a method of classifying and recording financial transactions. This method provides an accurate way of recording the changing values in the financial accounts of a business caused by these financial transactions. The debit and credits classification method also identifies the flow of economic value that takes place in every financial transaction where economic value transfers from a source, credit, to a destination, debit. In summary then, we should remember that debits and credits were first used by the Venetian merchants of Italy in the 15th century. They were first documented in Latin by Lucia Pacioli in 1494 and were later translated into English in the 16th century. We should remember that the debit and credit concept is a key part of the double entry bookkeeping system, and that the double entry bookkeeping system was created to deal with the increased financial complexities involving many different stakeholders that also included the recently emerging banks and investors. We should also remember the English term debit and credit are derived from the Latin terms creditor and debitor, which explains where we get the abbreviation DR for debit. The Venetian merchants used the terms credit and debit because it reflected the common financial transaction that involves someone entrusting something, creditor, and then someone owing debitor. In the 500 years since the terms debit and credit were translated from Latin, English has added many different meanings to these terms. It is vital to remember that the terms debit and credit, as used in accounting, have no relationship with any other meaning and use of these terms. The terms debit and credit are used in the double entry bookkeeping system as a method of classifying and recording financial transactions. The debit and credit classification method describes and records the flow of economic value that takes place in every financial transaction where economic value transfers from a source, credit, to a destination, debit.